In the last video, we have seen about the verification of Kirchhoff's current law using theoretically. Now we are going to do this practically. So we are going to use this practical diagram already explained in the last video about this circuit diagram. In this video, we'll move on to the PHET Proda virtual lab. For that, click the link given in the Moodle. And then you will move on to this website, that is PHET Colorado lab, this virtual lab. Here you will see the elements on the left side, and here the meters to measure, voltmeter, ammeters. And then here in the circuit diagram, what you want to see, electrons or conventional current direction. And this one, if you want to the battery type or the source type. Now I'm going to use the source type. So I am changing. If I am clicking the battery typings here, battery, wire, in light bulb, resistor will come. Now I am going to use this voltage source. Now let us draw the diagram. For that you need two sources. Now you click and drag the source. If you want to rotate this, just you move like this. And then you need another source. You click and drag another source. You just keep the plus and minus properly. And now this, you give the voltage. You click it, and now the first source value is 5. So now I have set it to 5 volts. And again, you click this. This is 2 volts. You can drag this, use this also. So 2 volts. So 2 volts are set. And now we need here 2 ohm resistor. So I am using, drag this resistor here and connect. Connected. And now you give the value here 10 ohms. So I am changing this to 2 ohms. And now we need another resistor here. 2 ohms. So double click it and change the value. 2 ohms. And now here we need here one ammeter. So here the ammeter is here connected here. Connected. Connected means this round will come. And then another one ammeter. So in order to connect ammeter, you have to connect it in series. And now you need one more resistor in the middle. So now this, the value of this resistor is, double click and change the value as 1 ohm. And now you have to connect using wires. So here, take this wire and you connect first between these two connected. So this gray color line. And now here you need one more ammeter to measure this current, this 1 ohm resistor. Suppose if you want this values, means here you click values, then 2 ohm, this 2 volt source, 5 volt source, so 1 ohm. You want values here, you select this, then ammeter you need, click and drag it, you rotate it, and you connect this in between. Here it is connected, but here it is not connected. So you need one wire. For that you take this, rotate this and drag it to this part. At the junction. Now you have to finish this connection using the wires. And join these two. Here, now the circuit is closed. Before that, no electrons flow. Now circuit is closed, the electrons start flowing in this circuit. But here, no flow of electrons since the circuit is open here. So, but see, the flow of the direction of flow of electrons, now it is in this direction, minus to circuit to plus. You already know that the direction of flow of electrons is opposite to the direction of current. Current flows from plus to circuit, then to minus. Here, this is the direction of flow of electrons. Suppose if you want the current direction, here you select conventional. Now see, this is the current direction, plus to circuit to minus. And now you connect this circuit also. And another wire. You see here, these two ammeters carries current, but here no current. Now connected. So now see, here also current flows in this circuit, but it is very slow. That means very low amount of current. Here only 0.13 amps. Here 1.62 amps. Here 1.75 amps. So here only mere amount of current. So that the speed is also very low. See, it's moving. Current is flowing, but it's very low. Now you write this reading. Current flowing through the 2 ohm resistor is 1.62 amps. Current flowing through this 2 ohm amps is 0.13 amps. Here 1.7 amps, 5 amps. Already we have calculated this value theoretically. Now practically we have found this value and you just substitute all these values in the tabular column. So in the Word document, you substitute the values in this document. 1.65 amps. Here you are getting 1.62, 1.12, whatever you are getting, you just substitute and then add this outgoing current 1.75 amps. That is the current flowing through 1 ohm, this resistor, this ammeter current. Here you have to write this resistor current, this here you have to write, this resistor you have to write here. And then find the total and verify it experimentally. So here you will receive one assignment problem, an assignment circuit diagram. So for that circuit diagram, write it in the observation, not this circuit diagram. This is a sample for you. So you just, the remaining things same to verify Kirchhoff's current law for the given circuit. The given circuit is different. So you have to just verify the Kirchhoff's current law for that given circuit. The formula you write and then derive. You can use any method for theoretical calculations and find the answers. Say, write the procedure. Apparatus required for your circuit. What are the apparatus required? You have to write. And then finally, this tabulation. You substitute the values what you get from the practical, that is virtual lab. You just take a photocopy of this or just print this page and then send it as a assignment for this week. You have to send this photo as well as your Word document also. That is Word document. Actually, you have to write it in the observation note and then take a photo and send it as an observation. Not the Word document. Just take the photo of your observation note and send it. Thank you.